Hello, Elizabeth.
I thought you said...
It takes time, Lizzie, a lot of time.
Bit of a mess, aren't I? Still, no worries. Now that you're here, I'm feeling better already.
Oh, Sid.
You've heard a witness state that it is not in her character to commit a crime. You may believe this, but you must also remember that the witness in question has only known the accused for a very short space of time. The testified fact that she habitually went running between the hours of 6 and 7 p.m. does not necessarily prove that she did so on this particular occasion. You must also remember that the physical appearance, the potential ability, and the previous good character of this woman does nothing to lessen the magnitude of the crime for which she has been charged.
Nice day, isn't it? Especially after all that rain.
Yes, I'm so glad the rain stopped. I really missed my walks.
You come here every day, do you? Oh,
weather permitting.
Always to this park?
Usually. I like to sit and watch the people go by. Lots of people running round these days like you are. Must be very healthy, I suppose, but looks very tiring.
Yeah, well, you work up to it. Look, if you come here every day, I don't suppose you've ever seen this young lady, have you?
Oh, yes. I know that young lady. Haven't seen her for a few weeks, though.
Yes, that'd be right. How about Tuesday, 3 weeks ago?
That'd be the last time I saw her.
Now, you're sure it was Tuesday?
Oh, quite sure. As a matter of fact, she stopped and spoke to me. I was pleased because I was feeling rather lonely. You see, it was the birthday of my friend Edna. We always used to have a little celebration together. But Edna passed away 2 months ago.
Oh, I am sorry. What time would it have been when you were speaking to this young lady?
About this time, yes. I only come out for an hour or so because it gets too cold later.
Would you be prepared to testify to this in court?
In court?
Yes, you see, this young lady has been accused of a very serious crime. Now, if she was here when you say she was, she couldn't possibly have done it. But you're the only person that can prove a case.
Oh, I don't like the idea of going to court. But I wouldn't like to see such a nice young lady go to jail for something she didn't do.
Then you will testify.
I suppose I'll have to, won't I? When will I have to go?
Well, court's in session right now. I can take you there if you like.
Oh! All sounds all very exciting.
Well, my car's not very far away. It's just over here. I suppose I'd better introduce myself. My name's Jim Fletcher.
Fletcher, Amelia Hunter.
How do you do, Mr.
So it's up to you, the jury, to bear in mind the purely circumstantial nature of the evidence and to decide if the weight of that evidence is strong enough to indict Miss Parks as the perpetrator of this crime. Much has been made here today of Miss Parks' athletic ability. I would advise you to in no way let that influence your decision of innocence or guilt, as Miss Park's prowess as a runner has nothing whatsoever to do with this case.
Excuse me, Your Honour.
What is it?
New evidence has just come to hand, Your Honour. As it appears will have a great deal of bearing on the outcome of the case, I request a short adjournment to prepare a presentation of a fresh testimony.
Well, in view of the lateness of the hour, I'll adjourn the court until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Thank you.
All rise.
Oh! Well, look who's back in circulation.
Yeah, I was nearly going up the walls talking to myself in the pound. What's going on? Anything?
Well, I've just been having a fascinating game of dominoes all by myself, if that's any indication.
You should have stayed in the pound, eh?
No, there is going to be some excitement. We are having a party for Laurie's 21st birthday.
Yeah? Reckon the screws will let us?
Since when have we ever worried about them? Mm. I reckon if we go to Davo, she'll give the okay. We're going to make it a fancy dress.
Fancy dress? Mm. Terrific. means we can use some of the costumes left over from the panda.
Right. G'day. Oh, the happy wanderer returns. How's Sid?
Oh, we had a bonza day. He's still a bit crook, though. He's not as well as I thought he'd be.
I tried to warn you, love.
Yeah, I know. I thought he was going to be all right from his letters. You know, but he will be. He just needs a bit of looking after.
Yeah, well, who's going to do that?
Well, I've asked Mrs. Powell to keep an eye on him, and, of course, I'll visit him as often as I can. Do you know what I reckon? We should all knit him something really nice and warm.
Yeah, but I can only knit socks.
All right. You're for the socks. I'm going to knit him a cardigan. And, B, you make him a nice woolly cap to keep his head warm when he's out in the garden.
Now, hang on, hang on. We're going to be pretty busy with two lots of things on our plate.
Two lots?
Yeah, we're going to have a fancy dress party.
What bloody fancy dress party? First I ever heard of it.
Well, you haven't closed your mouth long enough for anyone to tell you, have you? We're having a fancy dress party for Laurie's 21st birthday.
Beauty butler! We could probably invite Sid.
Yeah, and he could wear all the things we're going to knit for him.
Yeah.
You're looking very fresh. Didn't you go jogging?
Well, I just started and I found Michelle Park's little old lady.
Well, that one you were talking about.
Yeah, that's right. I took her to court and the judge adjourned the case until tomorrow.
You're in the wrong job. You should be a detective.
Oh, yeah, well, I think it was more good luck than good management. I'd almost given up hope of finding her.
Well, good for you for trying. You'll be quite a hero amongst the women.
Oh, yeah, you can imagine how long that'll last, too.
Well, here's one person who must think you're a hero. See you tomorrow.
Good night, Meg.
That was wonderful what you did today, Mr. Fletcher. Things were looking pretty bad for me, but, well, I think this will make all the difference.
Oh, come on, Tina, you got some wool. I saw you with it yesterday. Well, we won't have enough if everybody doesn't chuck in. Oh, go on, Tina, be a sport, love.
Lord, I'll get you some.
Thank you.
Well, how's it going?
Oh, give us a go. We've hardly started.
Oh, just giving you some encouragement.
Oh, to that slave labour.
Yeah, I feel like an old granny sitting here knitting socks.
Well, you didn't say that when that school teacher was here.
Oh, g'day, love. How'd it go?
Great.
Oh, keep knitting. You can knit while you talk.
You mean you got off?
Not yet, but I'm pretty sure I will. Mr. Fletcher found that witness I told you about. Got her there just on time. She's going to give evidence first thing in the morning.
Oh, good old Fletch really came to the party, eh?
Yep. So there's not much chance you're going to be seeing me around here after tomorrow.
Well, that means we don't have to keep up with those bloody keep fit classes.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, thanks for your help. All of you. I really appreciate it.
I wouldn't count your chickens, love.
Well, this time I think I will. In fact, I'm going to pack my bags right now. Bea, would you come with me?
Eh?
Just want some company.
Yeah, sure.
Take your knitting with you.
But I might get away with it.
Mm. Wonder why she wanted Bea to go with her.
Oh, don't worry about that door. Just get on with your knitting. What did Michelle want to talk to you about, Bea?
Hmm?
When she asked you to go with her to her cell.
Just wanted some company, that's all. Well, anyone want a cup of coffee?
Oh, yeah, the lights will be going out soon. Lizzie, let's have a cup of coffee.
You can go without your coffee for once, Dor. We can knit by torchlight, can't we, Bea?
No, we cannot. God, Lizzie, you're going to have us knitting in our sleep at this rate.
Yeah, and how are we ever going to have any time to work on our fancy dress costumes if you have us knitting all the time?
Getting this finished for Sid's more important than mucking about with your bloody fancy dress costumes. Oh, bugger it. We can use your torch, can't we, Bea?
No, we cannot. Now, drink your coffee and put your knitting away. It'll give you something to look forward to in the morning.
On, Lizzie, you'll break the speed limit.
I want to finish this as quick as possible. Get on with me knitting. I'm making a cardi for Sid.
Well, that's very nice, but I suggest you slow down a bit. You're not going to do Sid any good if you make yourself ill.
How was he when you saw him this morning?
I was running late. I didn't have time.
Oh, but I thought you're going to see him every day.
Well, I'll drop in this afternoon after work.
Oh, don't tell him about the knitting, will you? It's got to be a surprise.
All right.
How'd you get on with the arrangements about the Meals on Wheels?
Oh, well, I haven't done it yet.
But you said you was gonna.
Yes, and I will. Look, Lizzie, I have a family and a job to do. I don't get much spare time. But I'll try and do it today.
Fair enough. Mrs. Powell, I've been thinking. I've been working in the laundry a long time and I'm sick of it. Do you reckon I could go in the kitchen work with Mrs. O'Regan? I get on real well with her.
Well, Faye Abbott's due for a change, I suppose. All right. I don't see that can do any harm.
Oh, do you reckon Dor could come along as well? For a change of scene? I mean, she'd enjoy kitchen duty too.
You really push your luck, Lizzie.
It's just that I'm missing Sid so much, Mrs. Powell. It'd help take me mind off it. And then if Dor came along too, that'd make it even better. Oh, you know what it's like when you're getting old.
No, but I'm fast finding out. All right, I suppose Burns can go with you, but look, you two behave yourselves.
Of course we will. You know you can trust us.
You say you remember the exact night because of it being your deceased friend's birthday. But how can you remember the exact time?
Because that's the time I go for a walk in the park. I like to keep regular habits. Then you know where you are.
How long did Miss Parks talk to you for?
Oh, about 10 minutes, I suppose. She sat down to catch her breath. She'd been running, you see.
And what did she talk to you about?
Oh, I mentioned that I'd seen her running through the park before, and I thought she was very good at it. And she told me that she was in training for some race.
Can you remember her exact words?
Well, not exactly. I mean, not word for word. My memory's not what it used to be.
Yet you're able to remember talking to her on that particular day at that particular time.
My memory's not that bad either. I'm not senile, you know, young man.
This case has received considerable publicity. Miss Park's photograph has appeared in the newspapers and on the television. You must have seen something of the case. It strikes me as strange that you've left it so late to come forward with your claim of having seen Miss Parks on the night of the crime.
Not at all. You see, my television has been broken for a long time now. And I hardly ever read the newspapers. The print's too small for my eyes.
Eyes that were, however, strong enough to recognize a photograph of Miss Parks when you were shown it.
Well, after all, a photo's much larger than print, isn't it? Really, young man, I can't understand why you don't want to believe me. I'm not in the habit of telling lies. I did see that young lady on that evening, and that's all there is to it.
Have you any more questions?
No, Your Honor. The prosecution rests.
You may step down. In view of the new evidence that we've just heard, my summation must differ from that of yesterday. At that time, I pointed out that the evidence against the accused, although purely circumstantial, was heavily weighted by the fact that she had the motive, the opportunity, and the ability to commit the crime. Her defense had rested on an uncorroborated statement that she was on a training run in the park at the time of the robbery. That statement has now been corroborated. I must ask you to retire now and consider your verdict.
Everything. Yeah, well, I hope Mrs. O'Regan doesn't come back in again too quick.
No, she won't be back for a while yet. She's got lunch cooking. That'll give us time enough. And I'll just make this nice rich cake for Sid.
Yeah, but how are you going to get it to him?
Oh, I'll manage that. You just go off and nick some stuff for Laurie's party.
Mm. Hey, do you reckon that's what Bea really wants us to do? Nick stuff?
Well, I can't see how bloody else we're going to get it. You can't see the screws turning on a spread for us, can you?
No, I suppose not. Okay. I'll go and see if I can stash some stuff away.
Yeah, it's going to be a real bash-up party. It'll be something to tell Sid about.
Yeah. Hey, Lizzie, I don't think you'd better break any more of those in there, because they're going to miss them for sure. And you don't want Sid getting egg-banged.
All I want is a nice, rich cake for Sid. He needs building up. I just want to see him get well again.
Yeah, and I know why too, you dirty old bugger.
Oh, you got a one-track mind, door.
I wouldn't worry too much.
Have you reached your verdict?
We have, Your Honour. We, the jury, have found the defendant, Michelle Parks, not guilty.
Don't go yet. I'm sure Miss Parks would like to thank you for all you've done.
Oh, I don't need any thanks. Just did what I had to.
I'm sure she'd like to see you anyway.
Well, I'll wait over here.
Mr. Fletcher, how can I thank you for all you did for me?
Well, most of the thanks must go to Mrs. Humber over there.
Oh, yes, I must go over there. Will you excuse me, please?
Sure.
Hello, Mrs. Humber, how can I thank you?
That's all right, dear. I'm so glad you don't have to go to jail for something you didn't do.
Well, thanks to you. You mentioned your television set had broken down.
Yes, but I'd like to
buy you a new colour set.
Oh, well, thank you very much, dear.
My pleasure.
I'd like to add my gratitude to Michelle's.
And thanks to you, Jim. Michelle's sure of a place on the next Olympic team.
Yeah, that'll be great. Just make sure you win every race, Michelle.
I intend to.
She must have been walking on air.
Yeah, she was. You should have seen her. She wanted to buy Mrs. Humber a coloured television set to thank her.
A coloured set?
Yep.
Really? I wouldn't have thought she had the money now she's out of a job.
Yeah. Well, she must be going to put the bite on Henry.
Mm. Well, I suppose we'll drop the Keep Fit program now the athletic star's gone.
Oh, I don't see why we should. It's become a very important part of the prison's activities. I'm amazed at how well the women have responded to it.
Well, frankly, so am I. They've always been dead set against exercise in the past.
Yeah, well, I must have hit on the right note this time. No, now that they're so keen on it, they may want to expand into something else.
Hmm. Fence scaling would interest them.
No, I think you're wrong. I think Michelle has stirred up quite an interest in sport and physical activity, and I think we should capitalize on it.
Well, they've never shown much enthusiasm for any of our other projects, so I wish you luck with this one.
Thank you.
You're going to need it.
Pushing the bloody thing.
But I always push it. But you can do it, see if I'm bloody worried.
I just wanted to get away from our cell as quick as I could.
Oh, and why do you want to get away from our cell? What's going on?
Well, we stashed some stuff in there, including a cake for Sid, and it smells terrific.
Yeah, and some stuff for the party.
What party? Laurie's party?
Well, we don't get that many bloody parties, do we?
Oh, look, I told you, don't do that. I want this party kept above board.
You don't reckon they're gonna let us have it, do you?
I've told you before, if you go to Davo with a fair question, she'll let us do a lot of things.
You reckon we should try and put back some of the stuff we nicked?
No, you'll only get caught. But don't take anything else. If Davo does knock us back, then we'll need it. In the meantime, will you keep your noses clean?
Yeah, okay. But listen, are we gonna decorate the rec room? I mean, you've got to brighten the place up a bit for a party.
Yeah, you'll have to do something. Hey, Lizzie, do you think we can stop knitting long enough to make some decorations?
Hey, I want to do something. You just take this back to the kitchen, will you, Dor?
Oh, aren't you going to come and have some lunch?
I'll be back in a minute.
Give up.
Mrs. Powell, Mrs. Powell!
What is it this time? As if I didn't know.
Did you do something about Meals on Wheels for Sid?
Yes, I did. I arranged it in my lunch hour. Satisfied?
Oh, yeah, that was real good of you, Mrs. Powell. Hey, listen, I got a bit of a secret, something I want you to help me with.
Now, look, if it's something else you want me to do for Sid, Lizzie, I'm afraid I just don't have the time.
This won't be any trouble. You said you were going to pop in and see Sid the Savo anyway. I just want you to give him something from me.
Well, you know I can't take things out of the prison.
Just have a look what it is.
It doesn't really matter what it is, Lizzie.
Made it myself in the kitchen.
Did you have Mrs. O'Regan's permission?
No. She wasn't there at the time, but she wouldn't mind. I mean, Mrs. O'Regan and me are real good mates. Sid hardly ever gets a treat, and he'd love this. Won't you take it to him for me while it's still fresh?
And how exactly am I supposed to smuggle that out?
Oh, you'll be able. They don't search you or nothing, do they?
Well, no, they don't. But I'm hardly able to tuck that down the front of my uniform, now am I? Lizzie, I hope you realise you've abused regulations by stealing the ingredients for this cake.
Who's going to miss a few lousy eggs and some flour and some milk? It's for Sid. You're a friend of his too, aren't you?
Oh, yes, of course I am. I don't know why I let you talk me into these things.
Then you're going to give it to him for me.
I'll see what I can do. But look, this is the first and the last time. Now, there's going to be no repeats, you understand?
Oh, Mrs. Powell, you make me sound unreasonable.
Heavens.
Set. Go.
Hello, Henry.
Hello, Amelia. Didn't expect to see you here.
Oh, thought I'd like to see her doing some of her training. I mean, I've got an interest in her now.
She's doing very well, too. Came straight from the courtroom to here. I think she's running to forget.
Oh, that's good. She certainly seems very fast.
Improving all the time.
I really didn't like telling lies in court, but I know it was worthwhile.
I felt pretty bad about it, too. But I knew she was innocent. Couldn't see her go under.
And when she does race, I'll be able to watch her on telly now.
How'd I do?
Best ever.
I'm going to do it, Mrs. Humber. Thanks to you, I'm going to win every single race just for you.
You're right, Henry. It was all worthwhile.
Oh, come on, Dor. You can do better than that. And as they're for Sid, they've got to be real good.
Yeah, well, I'll be a whole heap better if you weren't standing over me all the time, and he's not going to die of cold feet before I can finish him anyway.
Don't you dare talk about Sid dying. Don't you even suggest such
a
thing.
Yeah, well, I wasn't thinking about anything like that. All I'm saying is I've had no time to work on my fancy dress costume, and the others have started on theirs.
When you finish the socks, you can get on with your cosy.
Less than Michelle. She'll be well and truly over by now.
You reckon they must have let her off?
Yeah, that'd be good.
Hey, Mr. Fletcher.
What is it, Smith?
We were just wondering about Michelle. Have you heard how it went for her?
Yes, I have, as a matter of fact. She was acquitted.
Oh, so she got away with it.
What was that, Smith?
I was just saying she got away from here. Lucky Michelle. Thanks, Mr. Fletcher.
Come on, B. Tell us what you meant by Michelle getting away with it.
You heard me tell Fletch.
Yeah, but we heard what you really said.
All right, I'll tell you. If you promise not to go splashing it around...
Oh, we won't tell anyone. You can trust us.
I better be able to. Michelle told me the whole story.
Is that why she asked you to go with her to her cell yesterday?
That's it.
What do you mean, the whole story?
She did that robbery. Just the way the cop said she did.
You mean she conned us?
That's right. Pretty smart kid, that one.
Not so smart, or she would have got herself a decent alibi.
Oh, well, she did have that all worked out. You see, she accidentally discovered that the electric clock ran off the same system as the burglar alarm, and she intended to reset it for 10:30, by which time she would have actually been at a party with dozens of witnesses.
Well, why didn't she?
Her boss came back to work unexpectedly. Just as she was taking the cash out of the safe, she heard him coming. She was lucky she got away at all.
So she didn't have time to reset the clock. And the police found out what time the safe was robbed.
It's about the size of it.
So she gets away scot-free with 8,000 bucks in her pocket.
Five. The boss was lying about the 8,000.
Oh, but you must admit, it's still a decent little packet.
I'll say. Struth, that'll teach him for sacking her.
Oh, that's not why she did it. She wanted me to keep her so she could train full-time. She reckons she'll lose 50 bucks a week for the next 2 years, and that'll pay her food and rent.
Do you reckon she will, or she'll splurge the lot?
I reckon it'd be pretty hard to keep your hands off it.
No, I reckon she's only interested in full-time training. She'll make it last.
Yeah, well, I still reckon she's a bitch for not telling us the truth in the first place.
Yeah, we were supposed to be her mates.
No, she thought she couldn't afford to tell anybody. And I reckon she's probably right.
Well, why'd she tell you, B?
She's pretty sure she wouldn't be coming back here, and she wanted her mates to know the truth.
Bragging, you mean?
Well, wouldn't you? You've got to admit she's been pretty smart. She conned Fletch and her own manager.
Yeah, Fletch being able to con old Fletch.
Want to know how she did it? Well, they set this old duck up in the park. When Fletch went jogging, he met her, dragged her off to court as a key witness.
Bloody funny, isn't it? Fletch getting a crim off free.
And he'll never know it. You can't help but feel sorry for him.
Henry, I didn't expect to see you here. I thought you'd be out celebrating.
That's what I thought too. But Michelle dragged me straight from the courtroom to a full training session. Then she sent me over here to exercise your ladies. I think we're trying to say thank you.
Ah, no thanks needed. Just glad to see justice done.
She's working her heart out, Jim. Make the national titles for sure.
That's great. Come on, sign in, then I'll take you through.
Right.
You know, I've been thinking of expanding that Keep Fit program. With your help, I think we can make a go of it.
Of course I'll help.
Good on you. Come on, this way.
Right.
You know, I've been surprised at the way the women have responded to this program, you know.
You mean you're going to take this out for her?
Well, there's not much harm in it, Vera.
Much harm? All the ingredients for this cake were stolen. And besides that, you're leaving yourself wide open to act as a courier.
Oh, really, Vera? One cake?
This won't be the end of it. Once they've got you to do something for them, they'll demand more. Next, they'll be asking you to bring things in for them.
No, they won't. I told Lizzie it can't happen again. Look, she was just concerned about Sid and wanted to do something for him, that's all.
Have you checked it?
Checked it?
Yes, there could be something in it.
Oh, you don't suppose they're trying to smuggle a file out to Sid, do you?
They could be trying to smuggle something out. Can't trust these women.
Oh, stop it, Vera. You'll ruin it.
You've just got to be sure.
Satisfied.
I still think you're foolish doing this. You know it's against the rules.
Life isn't rules, Vera. It's people that count. One day you might find that out. And if you ever do, I hope it isn't too late.
All right, ladies, you can take a break. Mr. Lawrence and I have been discussing the Keep Fit program, and due to your enthusiasm, we have decided to expand it. I thought I'd let Mr. Lawrence explain it to you.
I wouldn't bother.
What's going on, Smith?
Nothing. We're just fed up with boring, back-breaking exercises, that's all.
But you're also interested.
Well, we have run out of interest.
Yeah. And running out of interest is enough exercise for me.
Well, would you like to hear what we got planned for you?
No.
Doesn't seem to be much point, Jim.
No.
Thank you. Put your handbags on the desk to be checked. Stand on the white line. Your name is Diana Jane Wolfert?
Yep.
You've been charged with soliciting and have been sentenced to 2 weeks' imprisonment, is that correct?
Yep.
Undress behind the screen. On the white line. Your name is Kathleen Margaret Hall?
Yes.
Speak up, is that your name?
Yes, it is.
You've been charged with theft and possession of stolen goods. You've received a sentence of 2 months' imprisonment, is that correct? Answer me!
Yes, it's correct.
Right. We'll change behind the screen and hurry up. Wolford can go to D block, Hall to H block.
I guess I'm going to have to leave it with you.
Well, if you like, miss.
Oh, no, wait a minute. Here he comes. I'll give it to him myself.
Then I have you been waiting to see you, Mr. Fletcher.
Right, thanks, Dave. Well, I didn't expect to see you here again.
I came to give you this.
What is it?
It's a present. Well, go on, open it. I know your other ones are in pretty bad shape.
Michelle, really, you shouldn't have done this.
Look, I wanted to thank you in some way. I had to take a guess at your size. I hope they're the right ones. If not, I can always change them.
Look, Michelle, I can't accept this. You haven't got the sort of money to throw around.
Oh, look, don't worry about it. I'm doing all right.
I see. Well, thanks all the same, Michelle, but I've suddenly lost my interest in running.
Well, she didn't. She was real beaut.
Must be because she likes it so much.
Well, how are we here? New chum in the old boarding school.
Hello, love. What's your name?
Kathy. Kathy Hall.
Haven't seen you in here before, have we?
No, I haven't been inside before.
What did you do?
Oh, I grabbed a handful of notes out of a shopkeeper's till. Thought he wasn't looking.
Well, you know what Thought did, don't you?
Yeah, fired a night cart and thought it was a funeral.
Yeah, anyway, he saw me in the mirror.
Well, how long did you get?
2 months.
Oh, that's not long.
It seems long enough to me.
No, don't worry. You'll be all right, as long as you behave yourself. The main thing to remember is the screw's against us. You stick by us, we'll stick by you.
Yeah, mustn't lag, love.
Never dob your mates in.
Or any of the other women, even if you hate their guts. Never give a screw any information under any circumstances, understand?
Oh, yeah, yeah, I wouldn't dob anybody in.
Well, okay, you remember that, you'll be all right. We'll look after you.
Oh, great. I was hoping I'd find somebody who'd show me the ropes.
Oh, yeah, that's one other thing. Any ropes you find, toss them over the fence and haul yourself over the top.
Dora and me are going to make some scones for Sid tomorrow.
I thought Powell said there were not to be any repeat performances.
Oh, I can get around her. When I go to work on her, she'll be putty in my hands. What sort of scones will we make? Fruit scones or plain scones?
You won't be making any scones, Birdsworth. You two don't think you'll be allowed back to the kitchen, do you? You abused that privilege.
And since when was working anywhere in here a privilege?
You were very lucky you didn't end up in solitary.
Oh, Mrs. Powell didn't dob us in, did she?
What did you expect? Try something like that again and you'll be in trouble.
Oh, look, all she's trying to do is cheer up a sick mate. We couldn't expect you to understand that, though, could we?
Watch it, Smith, or you'll be in solitary as well.
If you're going to put us all in the pound, it's going to be pretty hard to be in solitary. Oh,
I didn't think Mrs. Powell would do that to me. I expect they've kept the cake.
Oh, yeah, Davo would have taken it for sure. It's probably in the rubbish bin by now.
Now we won't be able to get anything out for Sid. Don't suppose we'll even be able to get that knitting out for him.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. Don't get too upset.
Oh, it's rotten to be old. Old, locked up, not able to help a sick friend. It's rotten.
Don't let us interrupt your work. We're just doing an inspection tour of the equipment.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, we certainly could do with some new equipment. Some of this is as old as the hills.
Yeah, especially the old thing that folds the sheets.
But I'm running better than some of this junk.
Oh, couldn't we have some new machinery, Mrs. Davidson? Some of this is pre-war.
Pre-war? It's prehistoric.
I'm afraid we can't afford to replace any of the equipment. Whilst it's still working, we have to use it.
Oh, never mind. We'll make do, Mrs. Davidson. Probably couldn't handle any newfangled gadgets anyway.
Well, it's nice to hear something other than complaints for a change.
There is something you could do for us, though, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes, miss? What's that?
Well, Laurie's about to have her 21st birthday, and we'd like to have a fancy dress party for her.
Where'd you get the costumes from?
Well, we've worked that out. If we're allowed to do it, we'll use the stuff left over from the pantomime. How about it, Mrs. Davidson?
Well, I don't see why you can't have a party in the recreation room. Oh. Yes, I think it's a very good idea.
Oh, gee, that's terrific.
Oh, thank you very much.
Well, I never thought I'd be at my daughter's 21st, eh?
Excuse me, Mrs. Davidson, Birdsworth's got a visitor.
Must be Sid. Is it Sid, Miss Bennett?
If you hurry, you'll find out.
Oh, Sid, I knew it would be you.
How are you, Elizabeth?
Oh, I'm real good. The thing is, how are you?
Oh, good as gold. Yeah, oh, I brought you some roses, but I had to leave them at the front desk.
Oh, yeah, them buggers wouldn't let you bring them in. How many did you bring, Sid?
A dozen.
Well, I'm going to count them when I get them. You never know if someone might have nicked them for themselves.
Oh, I'm sure they wouldn't do that.
Oh, you never know with some people.
I had a real bonza time at your house the other day, Sid.
I had a lovely day too, Elizabeth. I hope you can come again soon.
Well, I'm trying to get them to let me.
Yeah, you get quite a surprise when you do come. I've been doing a bit of work around the place. Starting to look better already.
Oh, I hope you haven't been doing too much. You know, you've got to take it pretty quiet.
Oh, I'm just doing things slowly. I must admit, I do get tired pretty quick. But I'm looking after myself. Don't want to be too tired when you come next time.
Oh, you want to take care of what you say in front of Miss Bennett here. She might get the wrong idea.
Well, it mightn't be the wrong idea, Elizabeth. Oh, well, thank you for your cake.
You got it. I thought Mrs. Powell would have dubbed me in.
No, no. Colleen said she cleared it with Mrs. Davidson. Well, she thought she'd better, but I got it okay. Oh, lovely and rich it was. Must have had half a dozen eggs in it.
Eight. Eight eggs. I should have known that Mrs. Powell wasn't a dobber.
Well, How are all the other ladies going?
Oh, real good. We're having a fancy dress party soon. Be nice if you could come, Sid.
What a lovely thought. Yeah, I'd like to see all my old mates again.
I reckon you could see them now. He could come in, couldn't he, Miss Bennett, and say hello?
Of course he can't, Birdsworth. Don't be ridiculous.
But he was in and out of the place before. What difference does it make?
He was here officially, but he doesn't work here any longer.
But he's the same person, isn't he? I mean, if he could come in before, why can't he come in now?
I'm not going to argue with you, Birdsworth. The answer is no, and that's that.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, Elizabeth. Well, we have to follow the rules. Good heavens. What was bells going off in this place? What's that one for? I've forgotten.
That's for our morning break.
And you better get there, Birdsworth.
I'd rather stay here and talk to Sid.
Come on your way.
Oh. Look after yourself, Sid.
Oh, well, Elizabeth, and I hope to see you again soon, very soon.
Oh, hi, Lizzie. Did you see Sid?
Yeah, and he brought me some roses, but old Vinegar wouldn't let him give them to me.
Oh, right. She's a mean old bugger.
Burns.
Anyway, how was Sid?
Well, he said he was all right, but he looked a bit tired. I reckon he should have somebody looking after him all the time.
Mm. Well, you'd better behave yourself then, Lizzie, so you can get out of here and look after him.
I intend doing that, Mr. Fletcher.
I'll believe that when I see it.
Oh, bloody screws. They're all the same. Doubting an old woman's word.
I didn't know they had men officers in here.
Oh, yeah, only a couple of them.
And that one's Fletch the Letch.
What, do you mean he...
No, that's just what we call him. He's okay. But the one who's a real pushover is Harrison. He's inclined to bend the rules a bit more than Vinegar or old Fletch.
Harrison?
Yeah, Terry Harrison.
Used to know a bloke called Terry Harrison.
Yeah?
Oh, it wouldn't be the same one, though. Can't imagine him ending up a prison officer. Oh, you'd have to be pretty bent, wouldn't you?
You will say that she gets them, won't you, Miss Bennett?
She'll get them. And I'm not in the habit of taking things from the prisoners.
Oh, of course not. Yeah, don't let Elizabeth upset you. There's a bit of the devil in her sometimes, you know. In fact, I wouldn't be at all surprised if she quite liked you.
Julie, would you type these for me, please? I'd like two copies of each. Oh, hello, Mr. Humphrey. How nice to see you again.
Nice to see you, Mrs. Davidson.
How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm coming along all right. Have to take things a bit slower than I used to, but I've made up my mind. I'm going to get back good as ever.
Good for you.
Mrs. Davidson, I was just wondering, would it be possible for me to see my friends in H Block? They were always sending me best wishes when
Mr.
I was...
Mr. Humphreys, I've already...
It's all right, Miss Bennett. I don't see why Mr. Humphrey can't have a quick hello with the women. In fact, I'll take him there myself. Oh, what lovely roses. Are they for Lizzie?
Yes, they are, matter of fact.
Well, bring them along and you can give them to her yourself.
Well, thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, Sid. They're beautiful.
Best I could find, Elizabeth.
Good on you, Sid. Nice to see you again. I knew they couldn't give a good man down.
Ah, of course not. Not an old roughneck like me, eh?
Well, you make sure you look after yourself from now on. You sit back and relax a bit.
Oh, I've been doing so much of that lately. I'm getting calluses on the
floor. Oh, yeah?
Well, there, anyway. Yeah, I can see you haven't been looking after this place. Hinge on that door's broken, and I saw a few exposed wires along the corridor. Could be dangerous, Mrs. Davidson.
I'll have them seen to, Mr. Humphrey.
Yeah, well, why couldn't we let Sid come in and do them?
Yeah, he needn't have to strain himself. I mean, I could hand him all his tools.
Yeah, why not, Mrs. Davidson? We could make sure he didn't overwork himself.
I'm afraid I couldn't take the responsibility. We have to consider his health. You do understand that, don't you, Mr. Humphrey?
Oh, but Mrs. Davidson...
I'm sorry, Lizzie. It's quite impossible.
Thank you for letting me see my friends again, Mrs. Davidson. Really giving me a lift.
Yes, I can see that. I hope you did understand why I was so definite about not letting you come back here to work.
Oh, of course, don't you worry about that. But do you think it would be possible for Elizabeth to come and visit me again soon? I'll really look forward to it.
I think that could be arranged.
You're a real good sport, Mrs. Davidson. Good heavens, I'm starting to sound like Elizabeth.
Thank you, Mr. Humphrey.
Oh, would you give my regards to Mrs. Morris when you see her again?
Yes, I'll do that.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes?
Would it be all right if I had a bit of a wander around the garden before I leave? Oh, just to see how the things are planted are coming
up. I'm sure that would be all right.
Thank you very much. Goodbye, Miss Bennett. Julie?
Mr. Humphrey? Mrs. Davidson?
Yes.
I think the women are planning some sort of party.
Yes, that's right, a costume party to celebrate Young's 21st birthday. I've given my permission.
Well, do you think that's wise?
Yes, I do. I think it will help their morale. And I would like all the staff to cooperate in making it a success.
I really don't see why women in prison should be allowed to have parties.
Because anything that lessens the tension benefits both the staff and the prisoners, Miss Bennett. How many times do I have to tell you that it is my policy to encourage anything that creates a greater harmony within Wentworth?
I think it'll only end up causing more trouble. And I hope you'll remember that I said so.
Well, if you are right, I'm sure you will remind me. But I am prepared to take that chance.
Because they're supposed to be helping with all of this.
They're going to see what else they can pick up. They're also checking the stuff they nicked in the kitchen.
Yeah, well, we won't need anything now that it's all on the level.
Well, I might as well check it while there are no screws around.
Here, give me a bit of that and I'll try and see if I can do something with it.
Oh, here they are. What'd you get?
Well, look, you can cut this up into thin strips and make a streamer, you know, chain.
Yeah, a whole meter of it.
Yeah, well, it's better than nothing.
And look what we've got here.
It's great.
Now that the party's all above board, we can split this all up and share it among all of us.
Can't we do, eh?
Hmm? Oh, hey, you did real well.
Look, what do you think of that?
Would you look at this? We got a budding artist in the family, huh?
Oh, it needs a bit of wire or something to keep it in shape, you know.
Oh, well, I think I can get that. Hang on.
Oh, can you, Doreen?
What's all this? Oh, it's just some stuff we're getting together for the party. Mrs. Davidson gave us permission.
And did she give you permission to take these too?
Oh, we got those from the kitchen.
You stole them. You might be able to get around Officer Powell, Birdsworth, but you can't get around me. Once Mrs. Davidson hears of this little escapade, you can be sure she'll probably cancel your plans for a party. And you've only got yourselves to blame.
Didn't you hear the bell? It's time for pre-lunch muster. I said it's time for pre-lunch muster.
Kathy.
Well, well. It is the Terry Harrison I used to know after all.
What the hell are you doing here?
Is that any way to greet your wife after such a long time?